views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
The following audio is via a Skype call.
You are listening to Animal Soul Wisdom Radio, tapping into wisdom of our animals, angels, and masters with Darcy Pariso. Tune in monthly to learn how you can better understand your animals and deepen your relationship. This hit show calls attention to the many roles animals play in our lives. Through stories and insights, Darcy shares how animals assist us in raising our consciousness and fulfilling our soul's purpose. These busy healers help us with transitions and challenges, love us, and want us to have more joy in our lives. Are you ready to see yourself through your animal's eyes? Learn how they're helping you and walk through life with more ease and grace? Working with ancient healing practices, Darcy can guide you and provide inspiration to move forward. To learn more, go to darcypariso.com.
Hello, everyone. I'm Darcy Pariso, and welcome to Animal Soul Wisdom on Transformation Talk Radio. During this next hour, we're going to experience some really incredible stories. And these are stories that have not only changed the lives of so many animals, but they've actually saved their lives in some cases. So my very special guest today is Dr. Nels Rasmussen. And I want to tell you that I've known Dr. Nels for several years, and he's helped me numerous times with my own pets. So Dr. Nels is the go-to doctor when there's no one else that's able to help, and he's the guy. So Dr. Nels of Healing Ministry for Animals is one of the best animal healers that I've ever known. So let's jump in and find out why. Dr. Nels, welcome to Animal Soul Wisdom.
All right. Thank you very much for having me on the show.
Well, it's really great to have you, and there's so much that I want people to know about you and about your work. So without further ado, let's just jump in. I've got lots of questions for you.
Okay, great.
Okay, you know, first I wanted to clarify that you work with animals, but you're not a veterinarian. You heal a lot of animals. So what kind of doctor are you?
Right. Yeah, I'm a chiropractor, and I just got interested in animals when I was very young, and just kind of naturally gravitated in that direction.
So you've always had a sense of this, even when you were working on people? Because I believe you were working with people, because I've seen you as a patient many years back. Yeah. And I think the animals were kind of sneaking in.
I started my work with animals as a chiropractor back when I was still in chiropractic college in 1978. And they were my first test subjects to learn how to do chiropractic adjustments. And then I moved on to people. But it was while I was in college and working with people that I was learning to do animals as well. So it's always been, I've always had kind of a shadow practice, you might say, of animals. And back in 2016, just a couple of years ago, I finally made animals my number one thing, and people now are my sideline.
Yes, I see that. I know. But it's really great that you can do both. I didn't know that you had worked on animals back in college, so that's great. So you have, you're a chiropractor, but you have a different method that you use that's not chiropractic when you work with people. I mean, with animals, correct?
Right.
Do they transfer over? How do you do that?
Yeah, well, as a chiropractor, and as most chiropractors do, I attended a lot of different technique seminars to, broaden my view of what was chiropractic. And at some point, I started learning more about energy techniques and low force type of chiropractic techniques. And so each time I learned something new, I just incorporated that into my animal practice as well. I seemed to have a natural knack for translating what I would do with people to being able to use it on animals as well. And so in 2000, I studied a technique called bioenergetic synchronization technique, which is a totally non-forceful light touch energy method. And As I got really good at that, about a year after I had started with people on it and felt like I was, you know, totally confident in its use, then I found a perfect test case with a horse that nothing else I could do to help this horse get off of back onto four legs. It was walking around with its right hind leg picked up all the time. And then I did the best work, as it's called, bioenergetic synchronization technique. I did my modified program on a horse, that horse, and within about 10 minutes, it walked away perfectly normal. And I knew right then that's what I was going to be doing for the rest of my career.
Wow, that's some feedback. And what did the people do when that happened? They must have almost fallen over themselves.
Well, you know, they had watched me attempt working with this animal two times before using my two best other methods. And so they were like, huh, well, I guess, you know, hopefully the third time's a charm. And when they saw it walk away just perfectly normal, they were standing there open mouthed, as was I.
Yes, but I also know that you're highly intuitive and that you work with energy and you see auras, you see meridians. So, you know, you've got lots of special tools in the kit.
Yes, that's the energies and auras thing. It's kind of, it's not something I can just turn on and off, but at the same time, I know that whenever I'm looking at a human or an animal patient, that I am seeing those things, even if my conscious brain isn't relating them to me in the way that sometimes I wished it would, you know. But I can see, I know that my hands automatically go to those places where I would see, if my conscious brain was letting me, I would be seeing the points.
So when you're working with the subtle energy, do you actually, I know that you're sensing it that way. Do you actually feel it in your hands? I know some practitioners might feel heat or might feel a blockage.
Yeah. There's many levels in my sensitivity in my hands. You know, having done this work, hands-on work with people and animals for 40 years, I've learned to just trust what my hands are telling me. And I can feel a kind of a sticky sensation when I go over a spot that has an energy blockage, as well as I can feel the tissues and what's going on in the tissues. And that's usually, there's a congested or lumpy feeling there. And I also learned how to incorporate a little bit of synesthesia, which is where you can use, you can have one sense cross over to another sense. So when I touch animals or people and I find an appropriate point that needs some help, and in best, we always match two points together, I scan for the other point with a light touch until I hear a tone in both, that's essentially coming from both of my fingers, that tells me, okay, now you've got a match.
Wow. You know, now I know why they call you the doctor that's magical. That is, people sense energy in different ways. And I think that it comes to us just as we're open, and it shows up however it's going to show up. We're all unique, but that's really incredible to hear about that. So what are some other examples, some other stories when you first were starting out, how this came together?
Yeah, well, let's see. I've just got so many. I've got on my website, of course, I have lots of videos. And for those who don't know what that is, that's healingministryforanimals.com. But those are more recent. I'm just trying to think of when I suddenly kind of broke into doing a lot of paralyzed animals. And the first one that I took video on was a little corgi named Ellie. And she had lost the use of her back leg very mysteriously. And she had been that way for a couple of months by the time the people found out about me. And so they got a hold of me, and I saw her, and she was basically immobile, and she didn't even care anymore. She didn't even want to move. She was so depressed. And so we did a session on her, and 2 weeks later, I was back in Seattle again, and we saw her again. At that time, she was interested in life, and she was dragging herself around, and her back legs would move a little bit, but she couldn't stand up on them. And so then we worked on her again, and 2 weeks later, it was totally, I mean, a whole nother dog. She was running around. She was still a little gimpy on one back leg, but she was running around. She could even like go upstairs and things. And it was an incredible transformation.
you know, I love looking at your website and even on Facebook too, the Healing Ministries. So what I found was, so healingministryforanimals.com is Dr. Nell's Facebook, is your website, and Healing Ministry for Animals is the Facebook page. And I've seen so many of those pictures where you don't think the animal's ever going to get up. I mean, they're literally dragging their lower half of their body, and pretty soon there's a little bit of, you know, movement, and it can happen pretty quickly too.
Yeah, I've had animals. I had a fellow carry in a German Shepherd that weighed about 120 pounds, and he had her back end in a sling. She could still use her front end, and so he kind of carried her into my office, and I started working on her immediately. And then I thought, oh my gosh, I should have taken a video, because, you know, she wasn't moving and this would make a great video. And then I thought again, oh, but what am I thinking? Of course, she's not going to just get up and walk. Well, that's exactly what she did. We were done with the treatment. She got up and walked out. So I missed my chance.
Wow, that's really amazing. And I can't imagine the gratitude of the humans.
Oh, yeah. You know, the fellow that was his companion for many, she was about 10 at the time. It was his companion for many years, and he took really good care of her. We saw her pretty regularly to keep her going, and she lasted about another year and a half before old age caught up with her.
Well, I know in my own life, I had a King Charles Spaniel that has transitioned about 3 years now, and he was having seizures. And with, you know, my work with you, that last couple of years of his life were so much better, because the seizures were still there, but the symptoms were greatly reduced. And then some of his hind end weakness was also improved. So the quality of his life was, you know, enhanced greatly by your work.
Yeah. And that's another good point, is that seizures are definitely another neurological phenomenon. And I've helped a lot of animals with that. Some that where they just don't have them at all anymore, and others where they are greatly reduced. So that's and that's something that most people don't know, is that, you know, there's actually help for that besides putting them on phenobarbital or some other medication.
Yeah, well, before you came along, he was a little drugged. So we were able to decrease the medication. So quality of life was so important. And he really wanted to stay. You know, I talked to him several times and said, it's okay to let go. And he was like, no, I want to stay. So he was able to. So I've always been so grateful for that, and so many other things you've helped me with my animals. And also we have some mutual clients. So I hear lots of great feedback.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we're soon to have another one, mutual client.
Okay. So we need to take a break right now. It'll be just a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to talk more about why Healing Ministries for Animals. So how this name came up. And also we want to answer questions of how the conditions that you treat. So we'll be right back. Thank you.
Bye.
Space of Allowing Radio with Coach Nancy Coco, welcoming all that wants to be present today. Tune in Thursdays every first and third week at 9 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com as Coach Nancy helps you find a space of allowing. Join Coach Nancy to explore what lives at your edges and to bring more of yourself home. For more information, visit NancyCocoCoaching.com.
Healing has a ripple effect. One person's healing affects everyone around them. This is where the power of sharing our stories can be so important. Tune in to Playing on the Edge Radio with Megan Edge each month on Transformation Talk Radio, as Megan provides you with ways of sustaining radical and powerful changes in your life. Enact the power of radical change. To find out more about Megan Edge, visit her website at meganedge.ca.
Are you ready to embrace your essence and the magic of who you are? Let me, Emily Perkins, hold your hand and walk with you as we go treasure hunting for the gold that lies within you. Tune in to Love Living Radio every second and fourth Wednesday at 7 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. For more information, visit LoveLivingHolistics.com.
Conscious Confidence Radio, a timeless wisdom with Sarah Maine. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio and join Sarah on an adventurous journey to the deeper level of meaning to move beyond today's world of constant change, confusion, and uncertainty beyond the shadow of fear. This hit show explores key concepts such as confidence, values, and attitude in a dynamic way. To learn more about Sarah and her work, visit SarahMaine.com.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
The truth is funny. Shift Happens with Colette Marie Steffen is excited to welcome Karen Benton as a monthly guest host. Tune in on the third Wednesday of each month at 8 a.m. Pacific time to regain confidence and trust in your capacity to create change in your life, your health, your family, and your well-being. Karen Benton is a mother, nurse practitioner, certified body talk practitioner, Franklin Method instructor, and owner of Limitless Living LLC. For more information about Karen, visit KarenBenton.com.
Hey, welcome back to Animal Soul Wisdom. I'm Darcy Pariso, and my guest today is Dr. Nels Rasmussen. So Dr. Nels, you're a chiropractor who works with animals that have a neurological or an energy imbalance. So I'm curious, how did you come up with the name, or why do you call your work Healing Ministry for Animals?
Yeah, well, it was kind of interesting because as a chiropractor working, at least in this state of Washington, that it's not really legal for chiropractors to work on animals. It's kind of a weird flaw, you might say, in the system in that a chiropractor doing chiropractic on an animal is somehow considered to be practicing veterinary medicine without a license. So so I got a little bit of persecution, you might say, got in some trouble with the authorities. And so eventually I just decided, you know, I'm just going to give up my chiropractic license and I'll get ordained as a minister so I can lay on hands since I don't do manipulation anymore. And so that's really why I chose to be a healing ministry for animals.
Well, that was very clever. I know all of your clients are so glad that you did.
Well, you know, and it's the way I thought of it was, you know, what the work I'm doing really is a kind of spiritual healing process. And while it may not involve prayer in a classic sense, it certainly works on that level of energy that, you know, prayer works on. And it certainly, and since it has miraculous effects, I thought, you know, I think calling it a healing ministry is a great thing.
Oh, I think it's perfect. It really is. And that is the same energy. You know, energy is prayer. It includes all kinds of things.
Right.
I wonder too, your website I mentioned is healingministryforanimals.com, and your slogan is when nothing else works. And I think that's perfect. You know, knowing you and knowing of your work, it's really catchy. But what's most important for people to know about that, when nothing else works?
Right. Yeah. Well, what's interesting there, and the reason I kind of settled in on that idea is that I like it when people have gone to their veterinarian before they come to me, and the veterinarian's, you know, done some tests, examination, maybe blood work, you know, x-rays, whatever, and they say, well, we don't know for sure, or we suspect it's a disc, but, you know, we might need to do an MRI, or it looks like it might need some surgery, or, you know, something like that. When it gets to the point where they're starting to recommend, you know, thousands and thousands of dollars worth of surgery,
I may not be totally inexpensive, but compared to that, you know, I'm a bargain. So, you know, besides that, when an animal has surgery, you're talking 6 months to a year of rehabilitation and at, you know, more considerable expense. And whereas when I start with my rehabilitation, I mean, it starts on day one. And, you know, it's usually most of my cases are showing, if not complete recovery, significant improvement within 3 months, and a lot of them within a month.
I can see that. I know my cases with my animals, they weren't, you know, super serious. They're very serious to me, of course. And it was even much less than that.
Yes. Yeah. It's sometimes I am totally blown away by how quickly an animal responds. It's just, you know, it's night and day. Like, you work on them on a Tuesday, and on a Wednesday, the people call you up and they say, this animal that hadn't walked in 2 months is already teetering around. And you're going, wow, really?
You must be so excited when you get those calls.
I sure am.
Yeah. You know, you mentioned about, you know, not only the neurological, but the energy imbalances, and the work that you do, it also addresses the emotional level when you're working with, you know, you're working with all those energy bodies. And I believe a lot of it is, you know, human to animal transference and their emotions behind physical illnesses.
Right. Yeah. The what I've observed is, and when I get a new client, my general practice is to do a consultation. It usually lasts anywhere from 15 to 45 minutes, you know, averaging about 30 minutes for a consultation, which I do for free. I want to know all the details I can get about this animal. And many times as I'm talking, I'm also picking up that this human is very, very stressed out. and when I can start to feel that their energy is interfering with their animal's energy, I gently introduce the idea that maybe we need to do a joint program for the two of them to really get good results. And most of the people are pretty amenable to that because they know just how stressed out they are. And I give them a really good deal when I do. It's not quite a two for one, but they get a really good deal when I do the both of them together.
You know, that's perfect, because how can the animal expect to let go of something if the person's holding on to it?
That's right.
So let's talk a little bit about the kinds of things that you treat, the conditions, you know, how you help the animals.
Right. Yeah. I recently was actually working with a Google Ads person, and she said, you know, you need to have a list of the kinds of things you've helped, and it needs to be really near the top of your homepage on your website, because people want to know that. So when you go to my website, you will see that just below a compilation video of animals that have gotten better through my work. And so the big thing that I focus on a lot is animals that have weakness or incoordination, paralysis, that sort of thing, that, you know, they're just not moving like they used to. And I like that because it's very visual and I can make great videos. Yeah. But there's also things that happen that don't include things that you'll see. People just say, well, you know, my animal just isn't their self anymore. They're not happy. I can tell they're miserable and I don't even know why. They think it might be in pain, but they're not sure. They can't run up the stairs like they used to, so they seem to be slowing down. And sometimes that happens even to animals that aren't all that old. And so it's accumulated stress and traumatic responses in their bodies that has gotten to the point where it's built up to where they just can't make themselves go anymore. It's kind of like when your computer slows down because of all the junk you've got in there, mm-hmm. you know, and you need to dump your cash and all that. Essentially, this work helps to dump that cash full of information that the body needed at one time, but now it doesn't need anymore. So that's how that works. And it's good for a lot of things: chronic diarrhea, emotional issues or fear issues like loud noises, that sort of thing. I've helped a lot of animals with who suddenly were startled by fireworks and then didn't want to go outside anymore, or would hide under the bed whenever they heard a truck go by. So yeah, we definitely we can help a lot of things that are beyond just the mobility issues.
Yeah. And, you know, I was looking at your list on your website, too, and you mentioned, you know, aggressive behaviors. And I don't know if people think about that, but, you know, that's generally fear-based. And
there's a lot of people that, you know, that I get calls for because there's problems and people are worried. So I want to just bring that up too, because I haven't so much recently.
Right. So, I do work with dogs that are like that. I will say that a lot of times when you have a dog that has an aggression problem, if it's something that they seem to have had for, you know, most of their lives, sometimes they need help from a qualified trainer, as well as getting their fight or flight system reset, which happens pretty much every time I work in animals. We reset that fight or flight system. And so that works great, but oftentimes they have essentially, the animal, through whatever has happened in its life, has sort of programmed itself to respond in a certain way. And it's beyond just fight or flight. It's just part of how they respond to the world now. And so a good trainer can really help them to not respond that way, to change their response. So it's something where me and another practitioner, you know, of that sort would get together and do some good work.
Yeah, and that often is the case, isn't it? It's a combination of things at times.
Right.
Yeah. So that reminds me that you are also on Martha Norwalk's Animal World on KKNW on this same station.
Yes.
And Martha Norwalk's a very well-known animal behaviorist and trainer.
Right. Yeah, we work together a lot with just these kind of issues. And I'm going to be on her show, in fact, this coming Sunday, the 11th, from 9 to noon. And as an extra bonus, my sister Linda, who's also a best practitioner and focuses primarily on people, she's going to be on the show too. And so we're going to both be working on the people and their pets.
Well, I'm certainly going to listen in. And that show is on from 9 a.m. to noon on Pacific time. So if anybody wants to call in, that's 3 hours of taking calls. So you've got a very, very good probability of getting on.
Right.
Yeah. So we're going to be coming up on a break in just a minute here. I think we have time. Maybe we should give the call-in number. We're going to be taking calls the second half of the show, probably that last segment. And the call-in number is 1-800-930-2819. That's 1-800-930-2819. Okay. And so we're going to go ahead and take a short break. So stay tuned. We'll be right back with Dr. Nels Rasmussen. Thank you.
Tap into the wisdom of animals, angels, and masters with Darcy Pariso on Animal Soul Wisdom Radio. Tune in monthly as Darcy brings insights on how to better understand and deepen our relationships with animals. Working with light and pureness of ancient techniques, Darcy, healer, animal communicator, and medium, is here to guide you through this process and provide inspiration to move forward. For more information about working with Darcy, visit darcypariso.com.
High-frequency healing for an amazing life with Source Light Radio. Join host Laura Barton each month on Transformation Talk Radio as she explores Source Light integration, a unique spectrum of energy, light, and frequency. Experience instantaneous healing and amazing shifts in consciousness with Source Light Integrations Radio. For more information on Laura and her work, visit sourcelightintegrations.com.
Demystifying the Journey on From Here to There Radio with your host, Diane Garris. Tune in every third Wednesday, 4 p.m. Pacific Time on TransformationTalkRadio.com as Diane helps you get from where you are now to the life you envision. Get ready to get unstuck and move forward. Every show features a new special segment, New Age Notes, demystifying hot metaphysical topics of the day. For more information or to work with Diane, visit DianeGarris.com.
Have you ever heard of the 90-10 rule? It goes like this. 90% of the time, no one is thinking of you. 90% of the time, everyone's thinking about themselves. And if you think of it like that, it takes the weight off, because now you're not being judged. I'm Megan Edge. I'd love for you to join me on Playing on the Edge Radio, Radical Change with Ease, with my co-host Dr. Pat on Transformation Radio FM.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Did you know that all of the shows on the Transformation Radio Network are available as podcasts to stream or download?
Really?
Check us out. Go to transformationradio.fm. We have business shows, spiritual shows, energy healing shows, and pretty much everything in between. Something for everyone guaranteed to inspire, educate, and transform. We are transforming the world, one listener at a time.
Welcome back, everyone. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Darcy Pariso, and I'm here today on Animal Soul Wisdom with Dr. Nels of Healing Ministry for Animals. Also, Healing Ministry for Animals is Dr. Nels' Facebook page and his website, healingministryforanimals.com. Is there anything else, Dr. Nels?
Those are the big things. I should say that when, if, because we've mentioned that I do a free consultation, a 30-minute consultation, the best way to get that is to just go to my website at healingministryforanimals.com and just scroll down a little past the first video and the list of conditions, and the next thing you'll see, it says free consultation, and there's a contact us button, and you push that, you fill out a little form, and that actually goes straight to my cell phone. And so when I get a minute, I have a look at that and try to get, I call it a quick response form so I can get back to people, because I know some people are desperate for help. And so I try to get back to them as soon as possible and start talking about what we could do to help.
And I've also noticed on your website that you have a free report. It's 3 crucial mistakes that veterinarians may make that leaves your pet in pain or paralyzed.
Yes, that's something I came up with because a lot of people feel like they need more information. And, you know, websites that go on and on and on forever, people get worn out. So they can download that that free report and read that at their leisure. And that gives them a little more information about what I do and how it works and, you know, how I approach helping their animal, that sort of thing.
I found it really helpful, and I like bullet points. I like brief, too, so you can scan, like you said, and then deeper where you want. Yeah. You also mentioned you have a YouTube channel.
Right. And it's the thing about what I've discovered is most of my people who find me on the internet find a video of mine, and that's how they end up getting to my website and getting a hold of me. But it's I could say it still hasn't gained the kind of traction I think something as valuable for the owner who's desperate should be. So I encourage everyone to go to my website and click on any of the videos on there, and then you can click back from that into YouTube and go and like my channel, like the videos, leave comments on videos, whatever. So that's what gets YouTube excited about something, is when they see interactions, and then those videos get shown to people who are looking for the kind of things that I do to help people. So that's why I get excited about, you know, talking about YouTube, because it's another way that people can search and find me.
And I really encourage people to do this, because it's one thing to talk about it, but when you see these images and you see these dogs all of a sudden, you know, dragging their whole lower body around and running around in the yard, and it's really amazing, and it's so you know, heartwarming. And the minute should you happen to know somebody that has one of these issues, you certainly want to encourage them to call Dr. Nels. You know, I haven't brought up my own events, and I'll just take a minute to do that. And then I have a couple more questions for you. There's just so much that I want people to know about you.
All right.
I mentioned Martha Norwalk's Animal World. I too will be on Martha Norwalk's Animal World, and I'll be on Sunday, December 9th. And that's a call-in program from 9 to noon Pacific time. And we'll be doing readings, Martha and I together, animal readings, intuitive readings. And then on December 1st, If you're in Seattle, I'll be at Interspace in the Seattle area doing intuitive and animal readings. And then back on December 13th, a Thursday next month, we'll be back on the air with Animal Soul Wisdom. Oh, and one more thing. If you are looking for a reading with your animal or yourself or as a gift, I do have some special pricing on my events page on my website. So it's darcypariso.com and my events page, D-A-R-C-Y. And Pariso is spelled like Paris with an O, P-A-R-I-S-O. So back to our questions. So Dr. Nels, I know that you do your work hands-on and also remotely. So how does that work? I mean, I'm familiar, but I'd like you to explain it better than
Yeah. Well, and, you know, I've developed actually two distinct protocols for doing the work remotely. One of them is what I call pure remote work, and I don't need to get on the phone. I just need to talk to the person about their animal for a while, hopefully see a video of the animal so I can really tune into what's going on with them. And then I just do some pure remote energy balancing. And that has been pretty effective. Then I was thinking to myself, but there's no sensory input to the animal. And that's a big part of what my hands-on technique does. So then I thought, you know, now with the modern tools of Skype and, you know, WhatsApp and all these different video chat things, people can get together on a video and talk, and I can get together with a client and essentially guide their hands to do exactly what I would be doing, because I can tune in and feel what's going on with the animal, but I can't touch them physically. So I just have the person touch them physically while I'm doing the energy work. And we have had some amazing results. There's one of my videos is of a dog down in Sacramento that I've never seen in person. And she was one of those ones that was dragging herself around the house. And then, you know, 3 months later, she is running in the backyard, you know, so and I'd never seen her. And then there's a cat in Toronto I finished up with a few months ago. And that cat was just one day the owner noticed that she was kind of wobbling, and every once in a while she would just, her back end would just fall over, and the cat would look around like, well, what just happened? It wasn't aware of what was going on with the back end. Oh. And this was a 19-year-old cat. So anyway, we worked with her, and it was a 3-month program, but by the end of that program, we got that cat. She now runs up the stairs and jumps on the bed.
I did see that. I also saw you working with a couple in Europe. I forget exactly where, but I know that you work, you know, not only in the U.S., but other parts of the world as well.
Right. Yes. I've worked with some people in Germany. I've got a person in India. I'm working with their cat. I'm doing that one pro bono because it is just so difficult. The India economy over there is just, well, let's say it's ridiculous. So they can't afford me for one thing. And the other one is that even if they could, figuring out how to get money over here from India is not easy. So I just decided, you know, I'm just going to work with this one in India just because this cat needs my help. And this cat has seizures and had a very weak and uncontrollable back end. And and that was due to a trauma of falling out of a third story window when he was like 2 months old. And anyway, he has gradually gotten better and better to the point where he can walk and play, and his seizures are down to about once a month now. So, and they were very frequent. So and we're doing pretty good there.
And, you know, you've got so many stories of some real drama and trauma and miraculous changes. I know that's why you're called the miracle worker. But I want people to know also that there's a lot of you know, smaller things that can easily be helped. And I called you recently because my dog didn't want to walk anymore. And she was dragging around and she was having some issues with her liver and also her right knee. And so you had me put, you know, do the 2-point system, put one finger on her back hip on one side and around her neck on crisscross on the opposite side. And you'd wait and you'd tell me when to move. And there are times when when I do this on either dog that I can feel the connection. I can feel when it connects. So
yeah. That's really interesting because I've done that technique a little bit on the radio, but not that much because it's kind of slow. So I tend to use the pure remote. But it's fascinating that so many people say after they've done a few points on their animals, they say, hey, I think I can feel those pulses that you're talking about. Yeah.
Oh, that's great. And so what's the difference between the pure pulse and this remote that I just described?
Right. So the when I'm doing a pure remote, I'm working as if I have the animal in my presence, and I just do the work on, you know, what I'm visualizing as if I was working hands-on. But there's no phone connection or anything like that. I'm just doing that by myself here in my home office. And then, you know, the first time, I'm not sure, I think it was the first time I did this was when my sister called me about her partner's brother and their little Cocker Spaniel. And it was, I think it had been to the vet for some procedure, and it had been since then just listless for a couple of days, just laying around, didn't want to eat, drink, or do anything. Just, you know, it was totally seemed disconnected from the world. And so I thought, well, let me just tune in and see if there's anything I could do. I was formulating my idea for how to do remote work. So I did that. I met this dog once before, so I visualized it, and I started doing the work as if it was there with me. And then it was like an hour later, I got a call from her saying, wow, the dog is bounced up and is, you know, demanding to be fed.
Yeah. Oh, but that's so rewarding. I know in my own experience, my dog was noticeably better after we did this work. And then the next day she was even better yet. And I would say after like 2 days, she was pretty much back to normal. So it was great. You know, I had been doing all kinds of things, and I'm like, what am I doing? I've got to call Dr. Nels.
Yeah. You know, it's funny because I have people who, you know, big clients of mine off and on for years, and they'll say that very thing. It's like, you know, I was struggling going to the vet, doing this and doing that. And then suddenly it's like, you know, at 4 a.m, it hit me between the eyes, you know, what am I doing? I got to call Dr. Nels. And, you know, and then we do something and their animal will get well.
Yes. And, you know, another thing that I mentioned while I was thinking about this show, I mentioned to you a little earlier, when I was thinking about the show, I recall that I don't know if many people know about this, but you have a transition package. When my King Charles Spaniel had transitioned, I had worked with you to do some, you know, emotional work, some grief work, and that really helped me. I mean, I felt better. I felt, of course, I had to go through the, you know, the grief process, but it helped me to move through it and to feel more, more at peace. It
was right. Really, yeah. The best work, the bioenergetic synchronization technique, has a great emotional healing component to it, where we, you know, directly address the issues that the person thinks about and the feelings that are involved, and essentially reset that person's fight or flight system around those issues. And it is very calming and helps people through that. I can tell lots of stories, but I see we're coming up against our break. So
we are, and we've got a caller. She's been so so patient. She's on hold. So hang on, Linda. We'll get to you. So let's take our last break, and we'll be back.
I took my love and I took it down.
Hi, I'm Shelley Ryan, host of Your Next Chapter Radio. When you're ready to start a new chapter, take time to get clear about what it is that you want your next chapter to look like. Imagine what you'll be doing, who you'll be with, where will you be, how will you feel when you get what you want. This could be your dream job, finding your love, retirement, a balanced life, a healthy, fit body. Whatever you're looking for, create a crystal clear picture of exactly what it is that you want. Then write your vision down in as much detail as you can and read it as often as you can to remind yourself of your what. You don't have to be concerned about how you'll make this happen. You just need to be crystal clear about what it is you want. If you stay focused on your what, watch God and the universe show you opportunities for how to take action and make it happen. If you need help getting clarity around your what for your next chapter, you can reach me at www.yournextchaptercoaching.com.
Are you ready to create a life you'll really love? Then you'll want to tune in to the hit show Life Design Radio, From Adversity to Awesome, with Susan DiLorenzo. live each month on TransformationTalkRadio.com. No matter where you are in your adversity story, Life Design Radio has got you covered. Get ready to feel inspired, enlightened, and motivated. For more information about working with Susan, visit SusanDiLorenzo.com.
Tune in to Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly Neff. This hit show will illuminate your senses and empower you beyond your daily stressors and hardships. Renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly will captivate you with far-reaching topics and amazing guests as you wake to the greatest version of yourself. Learn to tap into your intuitions, think critically about our world, heal emotional and psychological wounds, and follow your passions to live your dreams. The Lucid Planet. Welcome home. Visit LucidPlanetRadio.com for more information.
What is a brilliant culture, and how do we create them? Why are they important? Claudette Rowley has created a breakthrough five-step process to help you align your culture with your business strategy for exceptional results. Looking for a culture that drives organizational excellence? Listen to Cultural Brilliance Radio, the second and fourth Friday of each month at 10 a.m. Pacific and 1 p.m. Eastern on Transformation Talk Radio. To learn more or work with Claudette, visit culturalbrilliance.com.
Ignite your inner magic on Grow Your Soul Radio with Jane Matanga. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio as host Jane Matanga explores how to overcome your fears to help you gain the inspiration you need to awaken your path to joy. Learn the way to life mastery and the enlightened path with Grow Your Soul Radio. For more information on Jane Matanga and her work, visit enlightened-path.com.
In the snow-covered hills, till the landslide brought me down. Oh, mirror in the sky. What
is... Welcome back to Animal Soul Wisdom with Darcy Pariso and my guest, Dr. Naz Rasmussen. And so we have a caller on the line. We've got Linda. We're going to bring her on. I know we're running out of time. We're going to do as much as we can in this time.
Hi, thank you.
Hi, Linda. Hey,
hi,
I want to ask you.
Hi, Darcy.
Tell me about your cat a little bit about what's going on, and describe your cat so I can tune in, feel like I can really see her.
Okay. She's a white cat, and she has patches of calico on her. She has like a raccoon tail. She's sitting on my lap right now. She loves to be petted the whole time. Her name
All
is
right.
Cleopatra.
So What's happening with her? What's going on?
Having a lot of problems. She is coughing and sneezing, and they told me to give her some medicine, and that didn't work well for her. I'm giving her some Canipet, but she's not eating very much. She drinks a whole lot of water. She always has. And she has soft stools, and it's just, I'm having a hard time with her.
Right. So here's what I'm doing, because as soon as I got a good, clear picture from you and you started talking about her situation, I tuned in and found a point on the left side of her neck, low down in front of her shoulder, and another one kind of in the middle of her back, just a little behind her shoulder blade, and I'm essentially balancing the energy between those two points. And the sense I'm getting is that the one that's down there in the middle back is related to issues of the gut, the stomach, that sort of thing. So
yeah, that kind
we're getting
of
we're getting that balance. And what I'm doing for those who are listening is I'm essentially touching these places, and I'm waiting for pulses to synchronize in my fingers. And right now they're bouncing around pretty furiously. So it usually takes a couple of minutes for that to settle into a good, solid pulsing.
Right.
So, and how old is she?
13 years old. She doesn't
13,
have too many
okay.
teeth. She doesn't have too many teeth in her mouth. That's why I'm trying to feed her canned food. It's a limited ingredient diet, which I'm sure she doesn't like very much, but I tried to feed her something else, but she just doesn't eat it either. So it's just,
right.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, 13 is not necessarily, horribly old for a cat, but it sounds like she might be, for her, it's getting up there in years, just judging from her physiological state. I got good pulses synchronized on the left side of her body. So now I've found two more that are very similar on the right, and we're working on those as well.
Okay. And she's always been very skinny from the time I got her, probably about 4 years ago. And she had gained some weight, but now she's lost some more weight again.
So you acquired her 4 years ago, and was that from a rescue situation, or how did that happen?
Yeah, from a person who got her from a rescue situation. They had taken out most of her teeth already. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So it sounds like, yeah, she might not have had an easy life.
No, she hasn't. And I'm just wondering if Darcy can tell me if she's in any pain.
I've been feeling the connections that Dr. Nels is making, and it feels like magnets, kind of, when they kind of connect, you know.
Yeah.
As far as pain, I feel like there's a how can I explain this? There's a low grade, I don't want to call it a rumble. Like this chronic low-grade feeling throughout her, like her whole stomach, intestines, a whole lower part of her body. Like it's just not irritable exactly, but it's just chronic, and it's been there for a very long time. And at times it feels like it bounces up. Like if you were to look at some kind of a graph where it goes up and down and it varies,
right?
I feel like that happens with her, that at times she's keeps it sort of in balance as much as she can. Then at times it spikes up, and at those times she really doesn't feel well.
Right.
So there's the moderate low grade consistent pain kind of that has some degree of variation, but then there's some spikes where it's almost, well, I just really feel awful. And do you see that in her behavior?
Yes, I have seen that in her behavior. Yes, I have. And I know she has some stomach problems, and I think that she has some asthma too. It's just really difficult.
All right. So I have completed my balancing on her. I also found the feeling of trust was involved, and it could be as a message for you to just trust the process of life and even of death, that, you know, it all proceeds as it needs to. And partly it also may have been her own trust issues around what's happened being shuttled from place to place to place. But anyway, we cleared that up.
Okay.
And so I would love it if you would call into Martha Norwalk's Animal World on Sunday morning and let me know how that all worked out.
Yeah, I'm taking her to the vet next week again to see, probably for another blood test and see if she's her thyroid level and stuff like that.
Right, right. All right. Well, it's been great talking with you.
Yeah. Thanks, Linda. And, you know, call back in. Thank you for calling today. And we've got one more caller. I don't know. Maybe we can do something.
Yeah. Make it pretty quick, though. Rowan's
okay.
On the call. Yeah. Rowan's
Rowan,
there. Do you want to say hi?
Cat, name Jade. Or Jade.
Hello.
Hi there.
Hi.
Tell me about your animal and what you've got and what's happening.
My cat is Jade Tiger. And she's 16, and I've had her entire life, and she's just always been an incredible, healthy, athletic cat. And we've just come through a really horrendous experience over the last 6 months and been displaced, and now we're in a really great home, and it's peaceful, and her back end is falling over. It's gotten really skinny. She's chewing her fur off. And it's getting...
Well, I'm telling you, I'll tell you what. I am doing a reset on her, and we're going to run out of time, so we won't be able to talk much more. But I will continue doing that until I'm done. I can tell that she really is stuck in fight or flight, probably from all that stress. And I'll get that balanced, and hopefully you'll see a little improvement.
Okay. And I signed up for your free consultation, so...
Oh, excellent. Looking forward to talking with you more then.
And we're only coming to Animal World on Sunday also.
Oh, okay.
And to Martha Norwalk's Animal World on KKNW, the same station. Call in. Dr. Nels will be there.
Okay. What is the first word? It's hard for me to hear you cut out. Norwalk.
Martha Norwalk with an N. So it's Martha with an N, Norwalk. Yep.
Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you for calling. So first of all, thank you, Dr. Nell, so much for being my guest today. I hope everybody got a good sampling of all the things that Dr. Nell can do and how amazing he is and how he changes lives. And remember to call in Martha Norwalk's Animal World this Sunday. If you'd like to speak to him some more, check out my website, darcypariso.com, for events. And Dr. Nell, you want to give your website and any
right. You can join me at healingministryforanimals.com. or just Healing Ministry for Animals on Facebook.
And thank you, our listeners. And join us again next month in December. I think it's December 13th at 11 Pacific time. Thank you. Thanks, Benny.
Thank you for listening to Animal Soul Wisdom Radio, tapping into the wisdom of our animals, angels, and masters with Darcy Pariso. Tune in monthly as Darcy shares stories and insights on how to better understand and deepen our relationships with animals. Working with light and ancient techniques, Darcy is here to guide you through the process and provide inspiration to move forward. For more information or to listen to this show, visit darcypariso.com.
The preceding audio was via a Skype call.